Cyrus.
Count to three. Come with me, and you'll be in a world of...
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do.
You have found Daniel Donato's Lost Highway.
That lost highway.
Yes. Howdy, y'all. Welcome back to episode 55 of The Lost Highway. I'm going to dive right into it today. We're going to improvise, overcome, start something new, try something new that I've never done before, which is I want to go through each track of the new record that is actually coming out today, September 30th, 2021. This is new. I've never ran through each track before, and this music is so not new to me. So it'll be really interesting to sit down with my guitar here on camera or on audio for everyone who's listening and just run through the tracks in the final relationship that you have with music before it is released into the world. Very interesting. It feels like the last day of school in some way. And it's like, I'm going to go out into my own world of summer, and these songs are going to go out into the world in their own way and be perceived. And now I'm going to start hearing what people think about them and why the track order was this way. And it's like so many angles are going to come to life that my train of thought could never have really even conceived. So it's really amazing. So we just messed up. There's our first one, but I'm actually going to roll with this. So this will be the first song off the record. This is a song called Why You've Been Gone So Long. And we'll start it in, let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. Key of A or E flat.
Every time it rains, I run to my window, and all I do is wring my hands and moan and listen to that thunder. Can't you hear that lonesome wind moan? Now tell me, baby, why you been gone so long?
D White helping me out on finding the right vocals for this song.
Tell me, baby. Why you been gone so long? You been gone so long now. Tell me, baby, why you been gone so long?
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Wolf scratching at my door, Lord. Can't you hear that lonesome wind moan?
These harmonies were so thought out.
Tell me, baby, why you been gone so long?
Play along at home. Anyone who's a guitar player.
To do, but I guess I could get stoned and let the past paint pictures in my head and kill a fit of thunderbird and try to write a sad, sad song.
All right, yeah.
Tell me, baby, why you been gone so long?
I really do love a good lyric about cannabis.
Tell me, baby, why you been gone so long? You've been gone so long now.
Harmonies on this song again. It's
wolf scratching at my door, Lord. Can't you hear that lonesome wind moan? Tell me, baby, why you been gone so long?
I'll tell you one more solo now. Cue cosmic keyboards.
Why you been gone so long?
All right, that is the first track off Cosmic Country and Western Songs. Why Have Been Gone So Long? This whole record is inspired by the times I used to play down on Lower Broadway. And I still do play down there sometimes, but not as much. Like we're touring now, and the vision is to take what I learned down there and dress that into the and play that across the country. So you can't take Broadway everywhere physically, but you can take the inspiration of it somewhere. So this song we used to play in the Don Kelly band like all the time, and we played it completely different. And so when I got my hands on this song as an idea of one I would actually like try to play on stage and live in, changing the groove a little from that, we used to do it in this way, like, tell me, baby, why have I gone so long? You've been gone so long now. And it's like, it's actually kind of cool. It's like a J.J. Cale approach, but then it's like bringing up to A and... That whole thing is more Jerry Reed in a certain pocket. And I'm really fascinated by that country funk pocket. So to start a record with that country funk sentiment is one that I've wanted to do for a while. And so, because country has a lot of ways you can move to it, you know. So this next one is a fun track. We completely changed this one. This is a song called Waymore's Blues. Check out the intro on this one. John Radford's snare is freaking crazy. We ran it through this this old $25 microphone, and we threw a outboard reverb tank on it, and it's like J Dilla meets Yeehaw. So here we go, Waymore's Blues. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I woke up this morning, it was drizzling rain. Along the bend comes a passenger train. Heard somebody yodel and a hobo moan. And Jimmy's dead, he's been a long time gone. Been a long time gone.
Four part
long time gone on this whole song.
It's been a long time gone.
Long time gone.
If you wanna get to heaven, got a DIE. You gotta put on your coat and TIE. You wanna get the rabbit out the LOG. You gotta make a commotion like a DOG. Like a DOG.
Oh yeah. The percussion treatment on this song is simply efficient.
Well, I had a good woman, what's the matter with me? What makes me wanna love every woman I see? I was trifling when I met her, now I'm trifling again. Every woman she sees makes it feel like sin. It feels like sin.
Now that's not the original lyric, but I know that's a weird thing to do.
Makes it feel like sin.
But it's such a covered song that it has to have something that gives it its own identity.
I got my name painted on my shirt. I ain't no ordinary dude. I don't have to work. I don't have to work.
Yeah, I see the percussion treatment again. It's simply efficient.
I don't have to work.
John Radford on drums again. Check out his episode on Lost Highway. It's great. Tell him, guitar. Another Jerry Reedism. I really do love Jerry Reed. He and Bob Wills are really similar in like a way that they like kind of entertain in these spaces in between verses.
or stanzas rather. Now, here's the thing, is that was a groove, really, the whole song. That was a groove for a whole song. I think that's like a good formula for tracking songs that are not necessarily songs that you wouldn't overextend live. So like if you're playing a song live, I think, you know, you could have more than a beat over a song. And of course, you can do that in the studio, but on a song like this, I feel like it better serves this specific story, this specific character, in the way of just giving it one outfit rhythmically. But if you enjoy the concept of bringing out more, there's several videos on YouTube of us doing this, like into Back on the Train. We do it into other songs as well. It is also a song that kind of can, you know, slippery and gingerly find its way into another dimension, you know, which is what Cosmic Country, that's part of the vision I have for this. It's like the fact that, you know, you go from song to song to song to song, and it's like how a movie never stops. And so the movie of this record wouldn't stop if we weren't on this podcast. I just want y'all to know, because we make sure that there's no dead time in between any song. So whether that's live or that's on the recording, there's always a sequence that carries you into the next one. So this next song is called Fox on the Run. This song, if you like, as they say on TikTok, this song slaps. Lucy Cochran on the fiddle here. Here we go. I freaking love this song. Joe Fick on stand-up bass too on this song. All right.
On a golden hot morning sun, she took all the love a poor boy could give her and left me to die like a fox on the run. Like a fox, like a fox on the run. Now everybody knows the reason for my fall.
Yeah,
that woman tempted me down paradise hall. That woman tempted me, took me for a ride, and like a lonely fox boys, I need a place to hide.
Oh yeah.
She walks through the corn, leading down to the river. Her hair shone like gold in the hot morning sun. She took all the love this poor boy could give her, and left me to die like a fox on the run. Like a fox, like a fox on the run.
Listen to that upright bass slap, too. Oh, listen to Lucy's fiddle.
Oh. I'll have a glass of wine, purify my soul. I think about the world and the friends I used to know. I see a string of girls who put me on before. Game's nearly over and the hounds are at my door. She walks through the corn leading down to the river.
Yeah.
Her hair shone like gold in the hot morning sun.
Yeehaw.
She took all the love this poor boy could give her and left me to die like a fox on the run. Like a fox, like a fox on the run. We'll be right back.
the river. Her hair shone like gold in the hot morning sun. She took all the love this poor boy could give her and left me to die like a fox on the run.
Really hard vocal fill.
Like fox, like fox. On the
floor. Jake Bostick, just so we all know, that was when we were cutting overdubs at Zach Reynolds' house, the engineer for this song, for this whole record, the tracking engineer. And I forget what we were talking about, but he just, in his accent, drops these sentences that sometimes that just reminds you that like life is a simulation and that it's like a movie or it's like a TV show in which like the, you know, and he'll say things that are so like poetically Southern. And this was not one of those times, but it was still a funny time. And he was saying, well, by God, if Joe Rogan says it, you must live your life by it. And it was in the ending of the song there. And it had to stay. It's comedy is a good way to improvise, it sounds like. That's one of the vibes of it. Let's see. The next song, 14 Karat Mine. This song is a story song. This is a Gene Watson song. And this song usually has a lot of pedal steel and keys on it, but we didn't do that. And when I played it with Don all the time, we kind of took the tempo up and made it more of like a Texas style, like roadhouse vibe. Or like urban cowboy vibe, where it's like really busy hi-hats and really busy music, but with a slim musical makeup on the arrangement of the parts and instruments. Very fascinating to observe a song through this lens. Now also to sing it, what a story this song is. Just to satisfy your 14 karat mind. Here it is. Gene Watson did this song. Don Kelly did the song. Any country western bar in your town, they do this song. And now here's the Cosmic Country version of this song.
Like a fool, I thought that I could please you. And I saw you here tonight for things that shine. And I paid $7,000 for a bracelet just to satisfy your 14 karat mine.
Yeah.
Staring at these railroad tracks in Denver.
Yeah.
With a hurting head and half a pint.
Rhythm guitar completely changes.
And everything except my soul has been surrendered.
Kind of went into Bob Weir mode here.
Just to satisfy your 14 karat mind.
Yeah. Yeah, like Franklin's Tower, Bob Weir mode.
The cabin that I built in West Virginia.
Down, 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 down.
It was not enough to keep you satisfied.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I know this song's too well right now.
Occupation. Can't afford to feed a rich girl's appetite. And I wonder if you're still with Willie Jackson. And sometimes I wonder if he is still alive. And you know, his wife and children.
Nick Fry on that
just
harmony.
Just to satisfy your 14 karat mind. Staring at these railroad tracks in Denver. With a hurting head.
Everything except my soul has been surrendered just to satisfy your 14-carat mind.
Now we let this one go a little. Actually hear a phaser on the acoustic guitar.
Staring at these railroad tracks in Denver,
just for that solo.
With a hurting head and a half a pint of wine, and everything except my soul has been surrendered, yeah, just to satisfy your 14-carat mind, just to satisfy your 14-carat mind.
Now that whole blah-doo, that was a big John Radfordism that he was very intentional in doing. And in the studio, it wasn't hitting me as to why you would do such a thing. And he goes, well, this is a honky-tonk record, isn't it? Like, you're trying to take anyone who listens to this record and transport them to, you know, the best honky-tonk in the world, like Robert's Westernworld on a Saturday night, right? And I'm like, well, yeah, that's the whole point of this. Well, it's like, well, you wouldn't end that song pretty if you're playing it live. You would end it that way. It's like, oh, yes, right. Adherence to the vision. That is what friends should help with. Okay, so this is when we go to side B on the vinyl here. Thank you to everyone who pre-ordered that too on Bandcamp. 237 copies, which is cool. Let's see. Limited run. This is a Sad Songs and Waltzes. This is actually the only song that I've never actually played a lot live, but it was a song my dad was sending me constantly. Like, I'll listen to this one again. It's like you listen to it enough times and this song really lingers in your mind for a good while, and it becomes kind of this character you didn't know was inside of you. Like, that's what Willie Nelson, I find, has always done for me. It's like kind of reveals parts of me that I didn't know were in there until I had an experience that was likened to one he was writing about, and I was able to take that experience and like associate it with that song, and then that song kind of becomes my own experience because they're such similar vessels of the same thing. Sad Songs and Waltzes ain't selling this year. It was like nothing was selling in 2020, really, like in some way. And then it was also just a really complex Rubik's Cube of consciousness the whole year. And all the years are, but I wanted to start side B with a little bit of a a leaning into that core motion. One song, one feeling. Sad Songs and Waltzes. Side B of the vinyl.
I'm writing a song all about you. A true song as real as my teeth.
E flat.
There's no need to fear it, 'cause no one will hear it. Sad songs and waltzes ain't selling this year.
Yeah.
I'd like to tell about how you cheat.
That snare goes for 10 miles.
I'd like for the whole world to hear. I'd like to.
It goes forever.
Get even with you, 'cause you're leaving. But sad songs and waltzes ain't selling this year. It's a good thing.
No percussion that time, but just wait.
My records may say it, but no one will play it, 'cause sad songs and waltzes ain't selling
this song to me paints the scene. It would be the accompanying music to, like, I think what, like, a border town in Cosmic Country World looks like. It's so spacey, it's so slow, it's so slippery.
Records may say it, but no one will play it. Cause sad songs and waltzes ain't selling this year. No,
Fleet Fox is inspired.
Sad songs and waltzes ain't selling this year.
So the what makes a Cosmic Country record, I think, too, is a real attention to how much space you're painting in, just as kind of how Bob Ross talks about it, in the way of adding depth and adding layers to a canvas that is equal to the previous one and to the preceding one that you will be creating on. So really focusing on where we were making parts of the song wet, parts of the song dry, just as you would like inform a landscape. And so that song is like obtusely wet in certain places, like so much reverb, almost on everything. And then we just, the intro of the song and the outro there, we completely dried it up. Genius translation of intention to a actual execution on software and hardware, otherwise known as artist talking to engineer. So thank you, Zach Reynolds. This next track is the second single from this record. This song's a murder song, and like I love a murder song that is inclusive, like musically. Like you hear a lot of murder songs that are like, which are cool, but like you never like want to dance to a murder song. But like this song, I feel like you want to dance to. So joke's on you if you want to dance to a song about someone getting killed, but I certainly do. Darling Corey. Lucy Cochran on fiddle here. I was just trying to think about who else. We did a lot to this song. We ended up taking out a lot of things. We got real spacey on it. We tried other solo instruments that weren't fiddle. This one, and ultimately the trick we found to make this song pop in the way that it had to. Because when you're taking, this is a traditional song. So like when you're taking it out of the context of the world that it was written in, you're trying to dress it to come out into the world today and like shake metaphysical hands with everybody's ears, it's like it has to drop. There has to be a dynamic in which like the loudness of compression can really like show its full evolved force. Again, John Radford again helping like paint the vision here. This was so it was the intro on this song, like it's particularly fun. Darling Corey, y'all. Yep. Yeah. Yeah. Real restraint practice here. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. This song just feels like a train. It just feels like a train that's moving, man.
Oh, you can hear this low note.
Yeehaw. Yeah, that thing's such a cool little Roy Nichols-ism. Roy Nichols played guitar most famously for Merle Haggard. He was in Merle Haggard and the Strangers, and that's him on the start of You Know Mama Tried. And so Roy Nichols puts out some interesting data as a guitar player where he does sometimes really like flex, and he'll hit these amazing, you know. But then, like, sometimes he'll just, you know... It's like I'm not complaining about either one of those, you know. And so he kind of gives you the bandwidth as a someone in the country realm to like let you know that, you know, less is more in certain moments. And that particular bow down bow down bow down bow down, that thing is, it's in my soul. So it's really it found a place there. So it's kind of funny. It's like not. Music, like, isn't just you. Like, you are the vessel for other proper nouns that, you know, other people that inspired you. Because that was not my idea. It was just in my head. And it was something that Roy Nichols put in. Who knows what put it in his head and how it got in there and where it came from. Here's the one that... Not there. The next song here is... Ambitious. Thank you.
sustaining one note over this all, so to kind of create this dynamic tension of her voicing. Searching for it presently. Searching for the beat. Oh yeah. There it is. There it is. All right. Oh yeah. John Radford Phil. Brilliant. Tempo change, tempo change. Gonna get real fast now. Scary now. And we are back. Thank you for joining us here today. Thank you for flying Air Cosmic. Hope it wasn't too twangy. Okay, that was terrible. Sorry. That's a snare. Now, normally that really intentional frequency that was sculpted with Zach Reynolds and myself would bleed directly into a song called Love's Gonna Live Here by Buck Owens, which is how we've been starting a lot of Cosmic Country shows as of late, because it really is a, you know, it's interesting. The more you say things, the more they become real. And I don't know what real means, but the feeling of real, it seeps in my mind easier. Lingered the intention of my thoughts are more clear, and almost seems like it starts to happen in reality. So this song I just love, and I love Buck Owens so much. I love Buck Owens like I love the Beatles. Like someone you hear about people loving, wanting to know all the recordings, knowing to want to know all the versions, all the alternate takes, and the positioning. And I've been able to like meet people who have worked with Buck, like my friend Willie Cantu played in Buck's band on this actual recording of Love's Gonna Live Here, of the song we're covering. And when we played it with Don would always like kind of Texas it up a little by like speeding it up and having the bass walk in the solos, and just in doing what I call dummy dynamics, where it's like keep it simple, stupid, where like there's sections that are up, there are sections that are down, and there's a lot of complexity that can you can establish in the way, but ultimately the direction in which you're going is rather simple, so you want to establish that. And I think with honky tonk music that's a thing. 7 songs we listened to so far. There's only one more song, so thank you guys so much for listening through the new Cosmic Country album with me. This is wild to do. This is kind of, this record is an homage to the band that I discovered my love for country music in, was able to work with for over 400 shows, and I discovered parts of myself that were not yet there realized until I had the opportunity to play with this band, the Don Kelly Band. So this is a cool thing to put this record out into the world. And Joe Fix on this record, on this song here too, playing stand-up bass as he does, in the pure definition of what mastery truly is over a exercise such as this instrument. Beautiful. So thank you guys. Love's gonna live here, y'all. Love is gonna live here. Let's get it queued up. So here we go.
Oh, the sun's gonna shine in my life once more. Love's gonna live here again. Things are gonna be the way they were before. Love's gonna live here again. Love's gonna we
favorite Seal players, rather.
No more loneliness, only happiness. Love's gonna live here again.
Cue synth and phaser. Listen to that bass.
Yes, indeed. That is the long, never-ending tale of a Valhalla reverb. A very specific kind of reverb that I love to paint the ending of a song with. It's a very nostalgic sound. That, to me, if I'm thinking of what that sounds like in terms of imagery, it sounds like it's something that is going forever and ever and ever at an increasingly hyper speed. That will never be stopped because it's fueled by something that is positive and loving and ultimately truthful in its intention. Intention of truth. You don't always fully achieve the full truth, it doesn't seem like, but trusting in these elements that these songs talk about. Love's gonna live here. That is so true. Love outlives us all, it seems. This was a really fantastic experience to be able to go through and listen to all these songs and be able to share some of the technical execution that was inspired, that we tried to execute on these technical execution that we tried to have on these songs. Really interesting, like playing honky-tonk music on stage for so long and then bringing it into the studio, and the animal behaves a little bit differently. So I love how close we got to being able to execute our mission, which was to create a record that transports you, the listener, today to a honky tonk in Nashville, Tennessee on a Saturday night, specifically Robert's Western World and specifically with the Don Kelly Band. It's a very unique experience that had the possibility of something that was transcendent, which I believe in the live music world is something that we were always searching for and always looking for. And this one building just shoots it out every single night when that band was playing there. And it was a pivotal point in my life that I'm never going to forget. And I think very fondly of, and I think of all the time. And now that this record's out into the world, it's my love letter to it. So thank you guys so much for listening. Cosmic Country and Western Songs. Available everywhere now. If you're watching the video here, I was not very efficient in my framing, but I'd rather do than not do. And I want to thank the Osiris team for hosting the Lost Highway podcast, and Topo Chico for keeping us hydrated on most other episodes. I'm not enjoying one today, but literally every other episode I am. And thank you, the listener. We sold all of our vinyls that we were trying to hit. Shows have been going well, and we are trucking. It's just life is moving. Thank you guys so much. Go and check it out everywhere on all DSP, on all streaming platforms in the entire cosmos. Cosmic Country and Western Songs.
Osiris.